Your father is ever virtuous, and holy men after death have good inspirations. Therefore, the lottery that he hath devised in these three chests of gold, silver, and lead, whereof he chooses his meaning, chooses you. But what warmth in your affection towards any of these princely suitors have already come?
I pray thee, overname them, and as thou namest them, I will describe them, and according to my description, level at my affection.
First, the new Persian prince.
Aye, that's a cold indeed, for he doth nothing but talk of the poor.
Then there's the county palatine.
Well, he doth nothing but frown. He hears merry tales and smiles not. I fear he will prove the weeping philosopher when he grows old, being so full of unmannerly sadness in his youth. But I had rather be married to a death's head, with a bone in his mouth, than to either of these. God, defend me from these two.
What say you then? What say you then, the Falconbridge, the young baron of England?
You know I say nothing to him, for he understands not me, nor I him. How oddly is he suited? I think he bought his doublet in Italy, his round hose in France, his bonnet in Germany, and his behavior everywhere.
What think you then of the Scottish lord, his neighbor?
Well, he hath a neighborly charity in him, for he borrowed a money from the Englishman, and swore he would pay him again when he was able. I think the Frenchman became a surety, and sealed under for another.
You need not fear, lady, of having any of these lords. They have acquainted me with their determinations, which is indeed to return to their home and to bother you with no more suit, unless you may be won by some other than your father's imposition, depending on the cast.
But if I live to be as old as Sibylla, I will die as chaste as Diana, unless I be obtained by the manner of my father's will.
Name I tender as few as my own. Be satisfied.
Oh, calm, the
will, sir. Ask for me tomorrow, and you shall find me a grave man. Why the devil came you between us? I was hurt under your arm.
I thought all for the best.
Help me into some house, Benvolio, or I shall faint. A plague of both your houses.
This gentleman, the prince's near ally, my very friend, hath got his mortal hurt on my behalf.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo! Brave Mercutio's dead.
This spot begins the woe. Others must end. Now, Tybalt, take the villain back again. Either thou or I, or both must go with him.
Thou, wretched boy, shout with him, hey.
This shall determine that.
Thank you. Depends on me, pay my consolation, myself, and move it to woo thee for my life.
Move it in good time. Let him that moved you hither remove you hence. I knew you at the first. You are movable.
Why? What's immovable?
A joint stool.
Alas, good Kate, I will not burn thee, for nine need to be but young and light.
Too light for such a swain as you catch, and yet as heavy as my weight should be.
Should be? Should buzz? Come, you wasp. And faith, you are too angry.
If I be waspish, best beware my sting.
My own is than the blood out.
I have before to find it where it lies.
No, no, no.
What is young gentleman?
birth of love? It is to me that I must love a loathed enemy?
What's this? What's this?
Well, it's a rhyme I learned, well, even now, of when I dance with all. Juliet!
Anon, Anon, come, let's away. The strangers are all gone.
Thank you.
break Hamlet's skin with a sword point and kill him. If that does not work, Claudius has put a poisoned pearl in a glass of wine, offering it to Hamlet. Hamlet does not drink while he is fighting. Laertes cuts Hamlet with the poison sword, but the swords get switched, and Hamlet cuts Laertes with the poison sword. When Hamlet learns of King Claudius' treason, Hamlet stabs King Claudius.
Thank you.
in his grave rained many a tear. Fare you well, my dove. There's rosemary. That's for remembrance. Pray, love, remember. There's pansies. That's for thoughts. There's fennel for you. And columbines. There's rue for you. And here's some for me. We may call it herb grease, oh Sundays. Oh, you must wear your rue with a difference. There's a daisy. I would give you some violets, but they withered all when my father died. They say he made a good end. And will he not come again? And will he not come again? No. No. He is dead. Go to thy deathbed. He never will come again. His beard was as white as snow. All flaxen was his poll. He is gone. He is gone. And we cast away moan. God have mercy on his soul.
Remember thy squash and blow.
and Juliet, Nurse and Juliet. Romeo and Juliet are from two families that hate each other, but they love each other and are planning to marry. Juliet has sent her nurse to find out information from Romeo of what the plans are for their marriage. She has sent the nurse at 9 a.m., who promised to be back in half an hour. She has not returned, and Juliet has become impatient. When the nurse finally returns, Juliet is so anxious to find out the news that she does not give care to what the nurse went through to get the information. To teach Juliet a lesson and have some fun at Juliet's expense, she withholds the information Romeo has given her about the wedding plans.
Come.
bright and sinister, through which the fearful lovers are to whisper.
Oh, Grim looked nice. Oh, Night with hue so black. Oh, Night. Oh, Night. Oh, Lack. Oh, Lack. Oh, Lack. I fear my Thisbe's promise is forgot. Thou, oh, Wall. Oh, sweet. Oh, lovely Wall. You stand between your father's ground and mine. Show me thy cheek. Yeah.
pretend you were dreaming. If you liked it, we were proud to present it to you.